Tabby Starr, also known as KIC 846-2852, or Boyajian Starr, is named after Tabitha Boyajian, a Louisiana State University LSU astrophysicist who discovered the star's unusual dimming behavior in 2015. A rapid dimming in the brightness of Tabby's star, famous for its large and mystifying fades, has triggered many observations as astronomers hurry to try to get to the bottom of what is rapidly becoming one of the biggest mysteries in astronomy. More than 1,000 light-years away from Earth is the Tabby star that has been baffling astronomers since it was first observed. It is 50% bigger than our Sun and 1,000 degrees hotter. The astonishing behavior of the Tabby star was first detected by citizen scientists participating in the Planet Hunters project, looking at data from NASA's Kepler Space Telescope. For unknown reasons, Tabby's star has been dimming and brightening in strange and unpredictable ways. It has dimmed for a few days or a week at a time, and also, there's the fact that it grew fainter over the past century. Tabby's star is an F star, and F stars are supposed to maintain constant brightness. Therefore, the fact that it has long and short fluctuations in brightness does not make sense. So, scientists came to a logical conclusion that something had to be blocking the light. Some of the speculations from astronomers included the mass of planets and even alien megastructures built by an advanced civilization, which could be harvesting energy from the star and causing its brightness to decrease. The data from the Kepler Space Telescope revealed that the brightness of the star dropped by as much as 22%. If a mass of planets were involved, there would have to be more than 50 of them, perfectly aligned and marching in front of the star to create such a dip. So, what caused the dip? A recent study using NASA's Spitzer and Swift missions and the Belgian Astrolab IRIS Observatory suggests that the cause of the dimming over long periods is likely an uneven dust cloud moving around the star. Researchers found that dust is most likely why the star's light appears to dim and brighten. The data collected from the study showed that different colors of light are being blocked at different intensities. There's less dimming in the infrared light from the star than in its ultraviolet light. Any object larger than dust particles would dim all wavelengths of light equally when passing in front of Tabby's star. This pretty much rules out the alien megastructure theory, as that could not explain the wavelength-dependent dimming. So that means whatever is passing between the Earth and Tabby's star is not opaque, as would be expected with a planet or alien megastructure. Instead, scientists suspect a cloud of dust orbiting the star with a roughly 700-day orbital period. Why is dust the most probable cause? The results from the study suggest that the objects causing the long-period dimming of Tabby's star are not more than a few micrometers in diameter, about 1/10,000th of an inch. From the star's ultraviolet light, it was determined that the blocking particles must be bigger than interstellar dust, that is, small grains that could be located anywhere between Earth and Tabby's star. Such small particles could not remain around the star's orbit because pressure from its starlight would drive them farther into space. Dust that orbits a star, known as circumstellar dust, is not so small that it would fly away, but also not big enough to block light in all wavelengths uniformly. This is currently considered the best explanation for dust, although others are possible. Even though we now know what causes the star's light to appear dim or bright, the finding still creates more questions. Like, where is the dust? How is it produced? And why does it exist in front of the star? Could multiple factors have created this phenomenon? Various theories about the dust's origin could be from comets formed by the star, consuming planets or expelling moons. Only time and more continuous observations from research will tell. Tabby's star needs further investigation and will continue to interest scientists for many years to come. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.